Hello students, welcome to my Abhyas. My name is Sahana KS and I am your physics educator. So yesterday's session was a very good one and today we'll be moving with the further topics and very interesting topics of electricity. So yesterday as we have studied about this electric potential, electric current, now we'll apply it in our daily life. Like how is it useful in our daily life? So when we come across this in this today's topic, we have mostly three main things to study. So the first one will be the electric circuit. Electric circuit, okay. And second one will be a very important topic, very interesting, that is Ohm's law. And the third one is factors on which the resistance of a conductor depends. Clear? So these three topics will be covered today for you people. And coming to the first one, this is an electric circuit. So whenever in the previous days and all, what you do is like when you just take out the parts of some device, there would be some circuits which would have some tiny particles in that, and we would be very mesmerized to see what are those tiny particles and how are they connected. But nowadays what is happening, because of the more exposure of social media, these things are being known to even a fifth standard student. So coming to the electric circuit, what is it? Electric circuit is nothing but it is a continuous and a closed path in which electric current passes. What is electricity? It is a continuous and a closed path where the electric current passes. So there is an ideal circuit which I'll be drawing it. And see, for every thing, for every mankind thing or for everyone's life, there will be an ideal. Similarly, we have an ideal electric circuit. So what is that? And we come across many important components in that electric circuit. This thing will help you in practical aspects, and even if you are willing to do your own inventions, that is also helpful for you. So coming to the first one, I'll be drawing one circuit. Please be concentrated because you have to be very keen on what component does which type of work. So first one, coming to the cell or a battery. I think you people know this. Battery or a cell, it is a source of energy, you can say, or source of current. Okay. After this, I'll just take these terminals. This will be a positive terminal and this will be a negative terminal. After that, I just take this and a loop, because I have said it is a continuous and a closed path, right? So next, here I'll just take a bulb. After that, I'll just extend this. I'll connect an ammeter here and then one plug key here. Okay, so this is what? This is a battery and the current is passing here. Right, then there is this bulb which glows when the current passes, then the ammeter which is of positive and negative ends, and then there is this key which is denoted by K. So here what I have done is I have used an ammeter. So in yesterday's session, when you just look into it, you know that ammeter is a device which measures current and voltmeter is a device which measures the voltage, right? So this ammeter, why we have kept here is we have to know how much current is passing. Okay, so that is why we have placed it. And this will be always in series because current is always taking the same path. Right. So coming to the first one, you have battery which has a positive and negative potential. So the current flows always from positive to negative. And then you have the bulb. Then you have an ammeter. And then you have a plug key. So what does this plug key do is, it works similarly as a switch in your home. For example, if you want to switch on the fan, what do? You just switch on the switch which is there, and then the fan is automatically on. It turns, right? Similarly, in this circuit, what happens is, if you remove the key, that is, if you remove this point, that time the current stops flowing. The current stops, clear? Because there is no connection between the two terminals, right? So the current stops. Then if you just put the key, what happens? The current starts flowing again because it is again connected. So this is how an ideal circuit is taken, ideal electric circuit or electric current circuit is taken. Now we'll just look into the components, how they are denoted. Because here battery I have denoted in two straight lines which are not equal. Positive is longer and the negative terminal is smaller. Coming to the bulb, there is one denotation for that. Then for ammeter, there is, I have put it as A, and then there is key. In the key, you have two types. One is the closed and another one is open. So we'll just look into the components of how a circuit is drawn and how it will be practically executed. So this is, for example, if I am making a circuit where the bulb should glow, then what happens? This I will be writing it in theory. Okay. Then practically, I take these things. I'll take a battery, I'll take a bulb, then I'll take an ammeter and then plug key, and I connect it with the wires. And then I see practically how it is working. So similarly, what happens here is, whenever a bulb glows, then the current is passing. So sometimes the bulb doesn't glow. Why? Because it may have been fused. Okay. So that thing, we'll learn it later. Coming to the first, next, what happens is, I'll be just explaining you how the schematic diagram, or you can say how pictorially you can represent these type of components in an electric circuit. So coming to the first one, there is a cell, or you can call it a battery. Okay, so a cell which is always taken, the positive in the longer end and the negative in the shorter end, we call this as a cell. Okay, next, another we have which is a combination of cell. So if you have or if you need a lot of energy or a lot of potential, then this combination is used, and here this is called as a battery or combination of cells. Again, cell or a battery, T-E-R-Y. Okay, so after this, coming to the next one, we have a closed circuit, that is closed plug key, which is closed. So whenever it is closed, what happens? The current is passing. Next, we have an open key, that is plug key only it is, but it will be open, and that is what we call it, that there won't be the transfer of current from one end to another end, because there is nothing in between. Clear? After this, we have a wire joint. So it will be denoted like this if there is a wire joint in the circuit. For example, if I have to connect another here, okay, another some resistor, if I have to do it, then what happens? This will be taken like this. Why? Because the wires are joined there. Clear? So after this, you have, okay, so I will just write it down, wire joint. Then another where the wires are not connected. So here, when you denote this, one wire is in the horizontal direction and another one is overlapping it, but those are not connected because I haven't mentioned with the knot there. So this is a connecting wire which are overlapping, you can see. Okay, so these are some notations, and then you have other notations which I'll be explaining. So moving on to the other components, first thing is, we will take a resistor. So this you'll be studying now. So the resistor is denoted by this, and then you have a variable resistor. So if you know what is a resistor, then you can understand what is a variable resistor also. But just keep in mind the denotation. The next concept is only regarding the resistors. So next one is variable resistor, which are denoted by this thing, or you can call it as rheostat. So variable resistor or rheostat. Clear? So next one, after this, you have an ammeter which measures the electric current, and then you have a voltmeter which measures the potential difference. So these are the main components which you will be using in an electric circuit, and I hope you have understood how it looks, so that whenever you come across any type of circuits, you can just let you know that how it is and how it looks. But nowadays, what is happening, only for practical purposes of the students in the labs, they are using these type of things. But you, in the motherboards and all, nowadays everything has been they have been reduced it to a small chips, and that is how the working has been possible. So in earlier days you would have the TV domes and all, but nowadays there is a motherboard and the TV size is also reduced because of that reason. Because before we were using these type of materials, and nowadays we are just using the motherboard and the chips. After this, we'll come across a very important concept, and this is a concept which you'll be studying in second POC also. And here, if you understand this correctly, then this is around 12 marks in your second POC. This chapter, whatever is there, is 12 marks in your second POC, and in your 10th, it is for 7 marks. So if you are opting for physics in the further classes, then this chapter is very important for you. So coming to the topic, what is it? It is nothing but Ohm's law. So there was a scientist in 1827. Okay, so what did he do was, he got to know what is potential difference, he got to know what is current, and he got to know what is resistance. So while doing some experiment, what he came across was, whenever the potential difference was varying, the current also would vary. But there was something or a glitch in the circuit. There was a glitch, because whatever the potential is there, that much of current has to come. But that was not being possible because of something. Weird. So as the research went on, he gave a statement and one very important term which gave a exact or the whole physics to be changed. And that is nothing but the resistance factor. So here in 1827, scientist name as George Simon Ohm discovered or gave a statement, and that statement is nothing but which gives the relation between the potential difference, the current, and the resistance. Clear? So what did he do? First thing, I drew one circuit right before. Okay, so instead of bulb, what do I do is, I take one metal wire. What do? I'll take one metal wire and I'll connect it, and then I'll put the ammeter here. Okay, so here I have positive potential and negative. Then the current flows. This is a metal wire which ends from A and B. So as this is going, what happens? The potential here, okay, the potential here will be, consider it as VA, and the potential here, consider it as VB. Because obviously, right, the potential is getting deferred from A to B, because the first pole or the first thing which comes to contact when the current is passing is A. After that, this is a metal wire. So metal wire means what? It is a conductor. It is a conductor means what is happening? The flow is more. The electron flow will be more, because I am giving external pressure also, and metal wire is also a good conductor of electricity. So what happens? The free electrons start moving only from VA to VB in one direction completely. So that time what happens? The potential varies from VA to VB. And then the current, that is the ammeter, starts deflecting. So as the ammeter starts deflecting, we'll know which type of, like what amount of current is moving in this metal wire. So here you can see the potential is getting varied. Clear? Yes or no? So what did the scientist do was, he gave the relation between this difference between the ends of the metallic wire and connected with the current. Like how is the current varying? So he stated that the potential difference V, okay, so that potential difference V across the ends of the metallic wire is directly proportional to the current I, which is flowing in that metallic wire. So what is happening? If the potential is getting deferred, then the current is also getting deferred. So usually it is I is directly proportional to V. That is because current is flowing first, and then the potential is getting deferred. Okay, so the current, whatever is moving through the metallic wire, is directly proportional to the potential difference across the ends of the wire. Okay, but there is one condition.